Welcome to Biology My Passion. I am Soumya Harikrishna. We are learning the chapter Photosynthesis in Higher Plants. We will learn about the site of photosynthesis, the pigments involved in photosynthesis, how they are organized inside the leaf, all this today. Photosynthesis happens within an organelle called chloroplast. It is called the photosynthetic apparatus. So chloroplast is actually found in all green parts of the plant. That means it is found on the green stem. It found on the green floral parts, but mainly it is found in the leaves. Where in leaves the chloroplasts are found? They are found in the mesophyll cells. What are mesophyll cells? Meso means in between. Phyll means leaves. So you know that when you see the cross section of leaf, upper epidermis and lower epidermis are there. In between the cells together called a mesophyll cells. In that upper layer is the palisade cells, which are compactly packed, rich in chloroplast. Lower side is loosely packed cells called a spongy tissue. So palisade tissues and spongy tissues together form what? The mesophyll cells. So these cells have a homogeneously arranged a chloroplast in them. Now, what is the color of chloroplast? Its color is green. Why? Because it has got a pigment called a chlorophyll. Okay. So chlorophyll is a pigment that gives green color to the chloroplast. Now we will come to the structure of chloroplast. A chloroplast is actually a double membrane bound structure. So this is the outer membrane and this is the inner membrane. These two membranes, as usual, any other membrane made up of lipids and proteins, that is lipoproteinaceous membrane. And in between this space is called a periplastidial space. Peri means what? Side. Plastidial means plastid. So the side of the wall of the plastid, we have periplastidial space. Now inside there is a proteinaceous substance. This is called a stroma. So the stroma contains DNA and ribosome. So chloroplast is considered a semi-autonomous organelle. And also it has enzymes which can help in the production of carbohydrate or ultimately photosynthesis. Now, inside there are disc-shaped structures present. The single structures are called thylakoids. Each thylakoid again is a double membrane structure. And on the walls of the thylakoid, different pigments useful for photosynthesis are kept. These thylakoids are arranged one above the other like a stack or a pile. Then, we call this structure as granum. Plural grana. So here 1, 2, 3 different grana you can see. Now connecting these grana, there are again thylakoids. These are not arranged as stack, but they are single ones connecting. This is called a stroma lamellae or stroma thylakoids or frets. Okay, so two types of thylakoids can be found. This is the granal thylakoid, which is a part of that granum. Granum is a stack of thylakoid kept one above the other. Interconnecting them, we have thylakoids called a stroma thylakoid or stroma lamellae or frets. We found the mesophyll cells contain chloroplasts. These chloroplasts are arranged on the outer surface, towards the outer surface of the mesophyll or towards the periphery of the mesophyll, with their broad face parallel to the cell wall of the mesophyll cells. Do you know why they are arranged like that? There are two reasons for that. First of all, so when more space is available or surface area is more, then diffusion of carbon dioxide from the atmosphere to inside of the chloroplast will be easier, that is needed for photosynthesis. Secondly, the absorption or capturing of sunlight by pigment molecules present in thylakoid also will be more. Now, talking about pigment molecules. There are different pigment molecules involved in trapping sunlight for photosynthesis. So, pigment molecule means they are specialized molecules which can absorb light of specific wavelength from the visible spectrum. So they are forming clusters, different types of pigment molecules form clusters. So the smallest unit of this pigment molecule capable of carrying photosynthesis is called a photosynthetic unit or PSU or quantosomes. So the pigment molecules categorized into actually two types. First category of pigment molecules are the major ones which we are all familiar with, that is chlorophyll. There is yet another group called carotenoids. Carotenoids include two types of pigments, orange color pigments called carotene and yellow color pigment called xanthophyll. So yellow color pigment, usually in green brown algae we have one pigment of a variety of xanthophyll called fucoxanthin. In brown algae there is a xanthophyll variant called fucoxanthin giving color to the brown algae. At the same time there is a yellow pigment called lutein also. Now we will learn the structure of chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is the major photosynthetic pigment in all photosynthesizing plants except certain bacteria. So it is called a universal photosynthetic pigment. Now chlorophyll can be of different types. Chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, chlorophyll C, chlorophyll D, chlorophyll E. Then bacteriochlorophyll and bacterioviridin are present in bacteria also. Now coming to the difference between chlorophyll A and B, those are the major pigments. Chlorophyll A has a formula C55. H72O5N4Mg, and so 1 magnesium, 4 nitrogen, 5 oxygen, 72 hydrogen, 55 carbon. So this is actually a pigment with a blue-green color. Whereas chlorophyll B has a formula C55H70O6N4Mg. So you can see here 2 hydrogen less and 1 oxygen more. Rest all structure similar. Now coming to the structure, if you take a very simplest cartoon structure of chlorophyll, we can draw like this. It has a head part called a porphyrin head and there is a tail part called a phytone tail. So porphyrin head and a phytone tail. This porphyrin head is hydrophilic. Hydro means water, philic means loving, so water loving. The same way phytone tail is a lipophilic, means this part is hydrophobic, it likes lipid, so it's hydrophobic but lipophilic because it's a hydrocarbon chain. Now if I take the structure of this porphyrin, it's actually having tetrapyrrole rings connected by methane group. So pyrrole ring means, you can see here a central magnesium. This magnesium is connected to 4 nitrogen and this nitrogen are connected to 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbon. So this nitrogen with the 4 carbon form a pyrrole ring. So like that, how many pyrrole rings are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 pyrrole rings. So we call it as tetrapyrrole rings connected to magnesium. This is the porphyrin head. Now what is the major difference coming between a chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B is nothing but chlorophyll A has a CH3 group, whereas in chlorophyll B it is CHO group or the aldehyde group. Chlorophyll A and B, they mainly absorb red, blue and violet lights. They reflect green light, that's why they appear green in color. So this structure is that of chlorophyll. You know that in our blood, in the breathing and exchange of gases chapter, we learned hemoglobin has a heme group in it, right? Iron group. So that also has the same structure. Only difference is instead of this magnesium, it has an iron group. The other pigments are carotenes and xanthophyll. So carotene has a formula C40H56, which is orange in color. Xanthophyll is C40H56O2, which is yellow in color. So you can see the difference is only one molecule of oxygen. Now, what is their function? These pigment molecules directly cannot do photosynthesis, but they capture light of specific wavelength, whichever they are capable of absorbing, they will capture those light energy and transfer it to the neighboring pigment molecules, and it will ultimately reach the chlorophyll A molecule, which is the chief pigment. And at the same time, they also prevent photo-oxidation of chlorophyll A molecule by converting nascent oxygen, means that atomic oxygen, into molecular oxygen. Usually the pumpkin, bell pepper or a tomato, all these are getting different colors like red and yellow because of the presence of these carotenes. Now we will see how these pigment molecules are arranged. As I told, these pigment molecules are arranged as clusters inside the thylakoid membrane or the membrane of the thylakoid. So here they have a group of pigment molecules with certain enzymes. So I'll give you an example. Imagine in your class we are making you into different groups to prepare for some competition. Okay, so I am dividing the class into maybe 6 groups with 8 to 10 children in each group, right? So each one of you is a pigment molecule. You can be a carotene, you can be a xanthophyll, you can be chlorophyll A, you can be chlorophyll B, any type. But there should be a leader in the group. Otherwise, who will take care of the responsibility? So one person should be the leader. That person is nothing but chlorophyll A. So the group has many pigments. One of them is the leader. Who is the leader? Chlorophyll A. Now, to assist or supervise, suppose if this is an inter-school competition, then the school has to ensure that we are putting up the best, right? So there will be teachers put on duty to assist each group. So imagine in this group, I am adding some enzymes also. Enzymes are like teachers helping in fulfilling the entire process. So all together, this forms photosystem. So in the thylakoid membrane, photosystems are arranged. Each photosystem has got many pigment molecules and enzymes associated with it. These pigment molecules are divided into two. There is a chief pigment or the leader, that's the reaction center. Reaction center is always a chlorophyll A molecule. The rest are other pigments or other students of the team together constitute light harvesting complex. They are also equally important, but who is the leader? The reaction center, chlorophyll A is the leader. So here light harvesting complex again divided into core molecules and antinea molecules. That is, just around the chief reaction center, a single chlorophyll A, other chlorophyll A molecules may be present, maybe another 20 to 30 chlorophyll A molecules will be there. They are equally capable. So they form the core group. Okay. Whereas the other pigments which can absorb light of shorter wave, this can absorb the longest wavelength of light. The other pigments can absorb only shorter wavelength compared to this. They together form the antinea molecule, which contains mainly 200 to 300 molecules of carotene, xanthophyll, etc. Hope you understood the organization. So the photosystems are present on the thylakoid membrane. There are different types of photosystem depending upon the wavelength the chlorophyll A chief molecule can absorb or the reaction center can absorb. If the reaction center chlorophyll A can absorb a wavelength of 700 nanometer, then that photosystem is called a photosystem 1 or PS1. But if it can absorb only 680, then it is called a photosystem 2 or PS2. We are going to mainly focus on PS1 and PS2 because in normal green plants, photosynthetic pigments are organized as PS1 or PS2. Whereas when it become to bacterial chlorophyll, it has got P810, that is not in our syllabus. Okay. Now, usually this PS1 is found in the stroma lamellae, means the connecting thylakoid. Whereas P680 and 700 are present both on the granule thylakoid. We already discussed that the source of energy that is captured during photosynthesis is nothing but the sun. So from the sun, different radiations are coming. All radiations coming from sun together called a solar spectrum. They are electromagnetic waves. So in the solar spectrum, only the visible spectrum is utilized during photosynthesis. Visible spectrum means the wavelength which includes a white light. That is our Vibgior. We know that white light, if we split into colors, we will get the spectrum of colors Vibgior. So what is the wavelength of that visible spectrum or white light? It is 390 nanometer to 760 nanometers. That is starting from violet till red. It is 390 to 760 nanometer. But the pigment molecules of photosynthesis can absorb between 400 and 700 nanometer. That means that includes within the visible spectrum. But the sun rays have got other radiations as well. Above 760 nanometer wavelength, they are actually infrared heat waves and radio waves. Whereas below are the X-rays, UV rays, gamma rays, cosmic rays, etc. Different pigments absorb light of different wavelengths. But chlorophyll A mainly absorb maximum of red light and blue light. So if we plot the absorption peak of this pigment molecules at against the wavelength, then it is called a absorption spectrum. So absorption spectrum is a graphical representation of the absorption maximum or peak of different pigments with respect to the wavelength. The same way, if you have a graphical representation of rate of photosynthesis plotted against the wavelength, that means we know that when more energy is absorbed, correspondingly more photosynthesis will happen. So if we are seeing what is the maximum absorption by the pigment, then it is the absorption spectrum. But if we are seeing the rate of photosynthesis, that's the action happening, right? The photosynthesis is the action. So if the rate of photosynthesis is marked against the wavelength, then it is called an action spectrum. These all seem to be very simple, but these are all very basic concepts of photosynthesis. You have to understand this thoroughly so that you will understand the mechanism of photosynthesis, which we will be learning in the next video. If you want to get more informative videos like this, please hit that subscribe button. Also, like, share and subscribe to my channel, Biology My Passion.